Over the last 25 years, the topic I have studied the most, by far, is leadership. I've spent about 3,000 hours on site observing and coaching executives in over 30 different industries. I've read somewhere in the neighborhood of about 500 books, most of which had something to do with leadership. From all of this research on leadership in 25 years, I've learned three things about leadership. The first thing I've learned is that labels don't lead. Leadership is not based on title, income, or authority. It's also not based on gender, race, height, size, or personality type. I have never seen a label that guarantees that a person is either going to be an effective or an ineffective leader. The second thing I've learned about leadership is that leadership is about influence. Leadership means influencing what other people think about in ways that generate better, sustainable results both for the organization and the people in it. Leadership means influencing what other people think about in ways that generate better, sustainable results both for the organization and the people in it. If you can effectively influence what other people think about, you can be a great leader. If you cannot, you cannot be a great leader. And the third thing that I've learned about leaders is leaders take the time to think. Every leader I've ever coached or studied or observed, always they answer four critical questions. And the four critical questions that I have learned, number one, what outcome do I want to improve the most in my organization or in my community? What is the outcome that I want to improve the most? The very first step of leadership is prioritization. If we try to do everything, we're not going to do anything as well as we could if we focused. Number two, the second question of leadership is, who do I need to influence? Who do I need to influence in order to improve that outcome? Who are the key individuals that are going to have the greatest impact on that particular outcome? The third question is, what do I need to influence them to think about? The third question is, what do I need to influence them to think about? Notice that the third question is not, what do I need to tell them to do? Telling people exactly what to do is micromanaging. Micromanaging is a short-term solution with long-term problems. If you always tell people exactly what to do, you're going to have maybe good short-term results, but you're going to have some big problems. Big problems like employees that cannot think for themselves, a lack of a leadership pipeline, and you're going to have employees, good employees, who leave because they want to go somewhere when they're allowed to think for themselves. The fourth question of leadership is really the art of leadership. How can you effectively influence the way other people think? What can you do that will be effective in influencing what other people think about? So on the bottom of that page, or the next page, if you'll turn to the next page, here are some ways to influence what other people think about. I'm going to go through these fairly quickly. What I encourage you to do as you think about these, I want you to try to think of a famous person that does this or somebody that you know that maybe is not famous, but that demonstrates this approach of leadership. So here's the first one, the exemplar. The exemplar is the person who influences other people simply by being watched. Nelson Mandela, Mother Teresa. A lot of people have never read what they wrote, but their behavior so perfectly modeled what they were trying to influence other people to do that they were leaders by being watched. I worked with a man named Lee. Lee was the regional director, the senior director of operations for a division of McDonald's. We would go and visit McDonald's restaurants all over the place. So we'd drive up, we'd pull in, and as Lee was walking into the restaurant, he would pick up a straw in the parking lot. He would pick up a napkin. So I didn't want to be a big shot consultant, so I picked up a napkin. I picked up a piece of paper. We walked inside the restaurant, and as we walked in, Lee would pick up another napkin, or he'd see a stray straw over here, he'd pick it up. And other people, the crew members inside the restaurant, started to see what Lee was doing, so they started picking up the stuff. By the time we left that restaurant, Lee never said a word to anybody about cleanliness, but the place was perfect. That's being an exemplar. Today, Lee is the chief restaurant officer for for McDonald's USA. And he's one of the greatest leaders I've ever seen, and he's so down to earth. Be an exemplar. The teacher. The teacher is the person who can take a big idea and break it down and break it down until other people can understand it, and now they can use the idea and move with it. If you have ever read Warren Buffett's letter to shareholders, and it's available to everyone, if you go to Google and you put in Warren Buffett letter to shareholders, you will see what I mean by a great teacher. He can take an incredibly complicated idea and break it down and break it down, and that influences what other people think about. The listener. Number three, the listener. The listener is the person who allows other people to put their ideas out on the table and develop those ideas until they become something even more powerful. Cody was the general manager, vice president of about an $800 million business unit. She was one of the greatest listeners I've ever seen. In a one-on-one situation, a small group situation, a large conference of 200 people, she had the ability to patiently listen while other people put their ideas on the table, and they were able to develop those ideas, gain momentum, and move into action. Number four, the storyteller. The storyteller is the person who can tell a down-to-earth story that other people can relate to, but it has a powerful point that influences what they think about. Abraham Lincoln, classic example. Number five, the facilitator. One thing that happens a lot when I work with somebody over a period of maybe 3 to 6 months is they'll say to me, "Hey, Dan, I learned something today." And I'll say, "What is it?" And they'll say, "I learned I don't have to have all the answers." And that's exactly right. The leader does not have to have all the answers. One way to be very effective as a leader is the facilitator. Ask open-ended questions that draws ideas out from multiple perspectives, and then summarize what you've heard and draw out more ideas. You don't have to have all the answers to be a great leader. The collaborator. The collaborator is the person who has an ability to bounce ideas back and forth with another person, moving the idea forward inch by inch until it becomes a reality. And finally, the coach. The coach is the person who shares insights with other people based on observed behavior. If you're working with an employee or a friend or whoever it might be, and you just study them, you just observe them in action as they do their work, and then later in the day or the next day in a private one-on-one conversation, you share with them observed behavior. That's much, much more powerful than just telling them what to do.